Republika Srpska pokreće tešku istorijsku bitku. Vlada je formirala Međunarodnu komisiju za istinu o stradanju Srba u Sarajevu i svih naroda u regiji Srebrenica. Članovi komisije su istoričari i eminentni stručnjaci iz 12 zemalja svijeta. Predsjedavajući komisije za Srebrenicu je glavni istoričar Instituta za holokaust Shem Olam u Izraelu, Gideon Grajf, a za Sarajevo stručnjak iz Izraela, Rafael Izraeli. U prvom intervju nakon imenovanja, Gideon Grajf je rekao da su mu činjenice najvažnije i da komisija mora biti lojalna činjenicama, istini i žrtvama. Sa izraelskim istoričarem razgovarao je Vladimir Bekić.
So, Professor Grajf, you are nominated to be a president of the Srebrenica Commission by the government of Republika Srpska. Can you tell us something about it? What should be the goal of that commission?
Allow me to refer to your question in a very principled, general manner. Every commission of investigation, and along the history there were many thousands, is obliged to be loyal to the truth, to the historical truth, to the facts, I'm a historian. For me, the facts are the most important thing. And to be objective, if there is something like this, we have to be loyal to the facts, to the truth, and to be loyal to the victims. This is the most important thing. This is our moral obligation.
But tell me, will Sarajevo and the international community accept that truth? You know, there is a formed picture about Srebrenica as one-sided genocide. Can it be changed? Is it too late now?
I don't think so. I see it as a challenge, an interesting challenge. Otherwise, I would not give my consent to be a member. Mm-hmm. I like challenges, and I personally like to change images. Let me give you an example. In the year 86, I started a very pioneer research on the Sonderkommando members in Auschwitz-Birkenau. When I started, at that time, the image of those miserable Jewish prisoners was horrible. They were defined as murderers, as collaborators. This was wrong. This was wrong. And I said to myself, I'm going to change it, believe it or not. After my first book and my other books were published, nowadays you will not hear one voice blaming them of being murderers or collaborators. On the contrary, the whole world accepted my philosophy, namely that they are the miserable among the miserable. So within 30 years, it took time, yes, I admit, I changed, really, I've changed successfully the negative image of the Sonderkommando prisoners, and now they are considered in a totally different way. So you see, it's possible.
And you are confident that it will be accepted?
This I can't promise. I'm not a prophet. But I hope that the work will be so professional, so serious and so honest that decent people will accept it. People who are not decent will never accept anything because they live in a different world. But this should not turn us from the way. We have to see the goal. The goal is the truth. And there is only one truth, not two, only one. And we will do all our efforts to find this one truth, yes. Not two, one.
Yes. Tell me, you're a professional with multi-year experience in this research. How you feel when someone from Sarajevo or someone else compare Srebrenica with Holocaust or equalize Srebrenica with Holocaust?
Oh, this makes me really angry and furious. The Holocaust, the crime against the German crime against Jewish people cannot be compared to anything else. Dot. I repeat, the Holocaust, the German crime against the Jewish people, which resulted with the brutal murder of 6 or even 7 million, according to last findings, cannot be compared to any other crime on this planet. Mm-hmm. Dot. It has to be very clear.
Mm-hmm. What are the main differences?
First of all, the universal aspect. If the Germans God's sake, would be successful, I wouldn't sit here today. Uh-huh. You would have to interview the wall, uh-huh. not me, Gideon Greif. The Holocaust meant, or the final solution meant, that this world will be a world without even one single Jew.
And what about Jasenovac? You used to say that Jasenovac is even different than Auschwitz, that in Jasenovac soldiers enjoyed in killing people.
Yes, that's a very clear difference. I mean, the Germans prefer to have a very sterile murder, not to dirty their hands. The Ustasha, on the contrary, they liked it. They liked to see the blood on their hands and on their bodies, parts of the brain of the murderers. They liked it, they enjoyed it. So two different, both were very, very cruel. The Germans were cruel, the Ustasha were cruel. Both were extremely cruel. But the way, the manner of killing was different. It shows about the mentality, about tradition, about patterns of behavior. So yes, there was a big difference.
And what is your honest opinion? So if we see Jasenovac and the way the people was killed, and Srebrenica, although it is a major crime, but can all two crimes be called the same word, genocide and genocide?
First of all, allow me to make a small correction. You used the word killed. It's not the right term, murdered. They were murdered. Killed is a car accident when you hear on the street. It's very important.
Yes.
You know, history is a science, and we have to be very, very, very accurate. Not every murder of a certain group is genocide. The intention is what makes the difference. What was the intention of the initiators of the crime? If they wanted only to annihilate a small group, a larger group, it's very different from one case to the other. The intention, this is what makes the difference. Nazi Germany wanted to wipe out all Jews from the. This world should have been Judenfrei, free of all Jews. And according to this monstrous plan, not a single Jew should have been alive if it would succeed. Thanks God it failed. It failed.
So, should we call the both or all three crimes, including, I don't know, Auschwitz, Jasenovac and Srebrenica, to call it with the same name, genocide?
Auschwitz and Jasenovac, no doubt. About Srebrenica, I would like to wait until we dive into the event, you know. If I would answer to you now, it means that I'm not a serious historian. I didn't start it. How can I come to a conclusion before I start the work?
Yes.
This is not serious. I'm a professional historian. I have to research, to see all documentation, to talk to people, to see photos, to see documents. It's a long process. If I would say what I think now, I don't have to do anything in the future. I'm a serious person and I would like to do a serious work.
Of course.
A professional work.
Yes. Professor, thank you very much for this interview.
You're mostly welcome.